So I'm going to show you a simple model which shows how we end up with high blood sugar levels. So you might have to use your imagination a bit here, but this is a cell in the human body. It could be any cell, so in the liver or the skin or even the eye. And this clear tube here, you'll have to imagine that this is a blood vessel leading to the cell. And here we've got a bowl of some glucose molecules. So what happens is we'll eat a meal containing carbohydrates. So that could be either starchy food like bread or pasta, or it could be sugary food like chocolate or anything sugary, basically. So a body is very efficient at breaking that down into individual molecules of glucose, which is released into our bloodstream, and the molecules build up in our blood. At this point, the pancreas will sense that we've got high blood sugar levels and it will release a hormone called insulin. And insulin acts like a key and it opens doors to our cells so that the glucose can get into our cells where it's used as energy. When we're living with type 2 diabetes, that process is not happening in quite the same way. So we'll be eating our meal containing a carbohydrate, and it will be broken down and released into our blood as individual molecules of glucose. At this point, the pancreas still might sense that we've got high blood sugar levels, but the insulin it's producing is not working properly, or it's not able to produce enough insulin. So we've not got these keys around to open the door to the cell, and so the sugar can't get into the cell and be used as energy. So the sugar can't get into the cell can't use it for energy, and instead it builds up in the blood, giving us high blood sugar levels.